And every now and then, someone finds the opportunity to come and shake the dust off of them and say, hey, look, you know, this is what this person's doing, you know, and I'm associated with them.
For a nominal fee.
Yeah. For a nominal fee, you could be associated with that too.
About if you spend a lot of time now versus back in the day, and did people take their dance seriously, if they were professional about it, if they weren't. And it reminded me of something you said earlier today about how you found dance to be a part of your life from a kid to an adolescent to an adult, and the questions that you had I've heard echoed in other olders and elders in the culture. How, you know, hip-hop dance, breaking was just something that the kids did. It had no relevance. It had no market for adults. And some people fell into that mindset, you know. If you could talk a little bit about that, you know, what society says about dance, about hip-hop culture, and how does that fit into an individual's life in a serious way?
I think with dance, like, you had to be... First of all, there has to be a venue. Like, where can you do it? Where can you enjoy it? Like, with any activity, anything you like to do, is like, where can it go? Where can you experience and this art form and have experiences with other people and build a culture? And, like, if it's not relevant to the masses, there'll be very few places to do it. You know? Like, so it's important that, like, there's at least the opportunity, you know, to continue what you're doing. And I think that's what happened, like, with a lot of those dance styles. You know, first of all, there weren't a lot of people who were really good at it, you know, that you wanted to learn from. And then if, you know, there were some people, like, where could you learn from them? You know, it may have been inappropriate to go to their homes, you know, and learn from them there, you know, like... You definitely couldn't do it. Where I'm from, Virginia Beach, you couldn't do it out on the street. The whole cardboard on the street corner crap. Shit. Out of my hood, you get arrested in a heartbeat. Like, even in the suburbs, you know? Mm. Like, the suburbs in the South. You don't want no black people outside, like, kicking their legs around and spin around on their back. And, like, dancing to drum-induced music. Like, that's a riot waiting to happen. There's a cop sitting on the corner, be like, there's three black people out there on the corner.
Moving very fast.
If a fourth one comes in, we're going to break that up. It's almost a riot. It's a gang! And yeah. So people didn't even see it like that. Sometimes I hear people talk about it. You know, I'm like, maybe in your neighborhood, but not in my neighborhood. Like, that didn't go down. So having the people around, look at it today. You can go to any, like, dance school, and there's a hip-hop class. It might be whack, but, you know, it's still a hip-hop class, you know? Yeah. And there's venues for it. It's filmed. It's all over the place, you know? Like, so there is a change. There's a change. And the people who were doing it then, you know, are now, you know, some of them wrongfully claiming that they had relevance and they've been doing the damn thing, and they want all these younger kids, you know, to give them credit for their contribution. All right, so we're going to go on to the next segment. Let's break it out. Peace.
Can you dig it?
Yeah.
Can you dig it?
Yeah.
Can you dig it?
This is DJ Baron Hulk Portier hitting you with Can You Dig It? So today we're going to 1978. We're going to visit a great band named Rolls Royce. And we're hitting you with Rolls Royce 3, Strikes Again. This track we're going to is a very classic track. It's Love Don't Live Here Anymore, and it's been sampled countless times. I love this track. I've heard reggae versions of it. I've heard hip hop versions of it. I've heard, you know, updated covers of it. So a lot of people redo this track. But you know, we're gonna pick one of my favorite instances of this track being sampled. So here's the sample first. It's Love Don't Live Here Anymore by Rolls Royce from Rolls Royce 3, Rolls Royce Strikes Again. Check it out.
Just a vacancy. Love don't live here anymore. When you lived inside of me, there was nothing I could conceive that you wouldn't do for me. Trouble seemed so far away. You changed that right away, baby.
You are so now that we've checked out the sample from Rolls Royce, now we're going to go to one of the instances of somebody sampling it, and I think that this brother did an amazing job. And we're going to talk about the one and only Ninth Wonder, coming from North Carolina. This brother just destroyed Love Don't Live Here Anymore. The way that he chopped it up is just fascinating to me. I never heard anybody chop it up the way that he did it. And he did it for this album, Charity Starts at Home. This is Fonte's solo album. This came out 2011. And the track that we're going to talk about is Not Here Anymore. If you haven't heard this joint, you need to go check this joint out. This is from 2011, Ninth Wonder on the beat. Check it out.
Went to the well and made a wish. Pray to God I stay around. Tigolo love to throw his weight around. On the same scale they weigh the fish. It's just what it seems. Sweet dreams are made of this. Holla at me if you ever been an underdog or set up an upset. Standing on the verge of your success. Steady bearing your soul to the world you undressed. Surrounded by your successors and the whores you ain't fucked yet. That's how I was getting it. I don't need the limelight, that's young nigga shit. I'm an OG and the G is for gentlemen. Yes, fine, Tigger spit, Amazon flame, watch Ninth rekindle it, cause iPad versus with the...
All right, so today for Can You Dig It, we got Rolls Royce, Love Don't Live Here Anymore, and the sample joint from Charity Starts at Home, Fonte, Not Here Anymore. This has been Can You Dig It with Baron Hulk Portier. Peace.
And I think that's the key. I mean, you gotta state the contribution. You know, like, what's your contribution? What did you do? You know, and it might be that as younger people, we just don't know. I get it too. I mean, you guys look at me as like older, you know, like, but like there's people who are older than me, you know, and they come and they say, well, you know, back when I was a kid, we did like this and I do the same thing that y'all do. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah. Let me see. You know? And if they can't show me, I'm like, okay, you ain't got no video. You can't do it now. Ain't nobody talking about your tail. Your po. Like, dude, something had to happen.
Yeah.
Well, what happened to you? Like, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a different mentality about that now. Now, like, I used to think like that, but now I think like, no, like, just because they don't have anything doesn't mean they're not talented, you know?
Yeah, some people are getting the shine, whether they deserve it or not, with others. You know, maybe they were a big part of their community back then, but who's left of their community now, who remembers and who gets to vouch for them? And it's not fair.
No.
And I get it. You know, people come up to me and say, yeah, I used to break and then I grew up. It's like,
man.
But it's sad. It's sad. Mm-hmm. And people still think that way. Yeah. And there's still this struggle. I mean, I have a full-time job. I have family in another state. You know, how do you, you know, remember, like, the relevance of dance in your life today? And it's important. And it's so sad when you forget or when you believe, nah, you know, I got to grow up and do other things.
I recently had, like, somebody very close to me who's actually younger than me, you know? Like, we grew up together, you know? And I saw his kids, you know? He's got kids now. And I was like, man, you know, they're growing up, you know? Like, you know, and I said to him, you know, I was like, dude, it's hard to believe. Like, he's like 15 years younger than me. Like, he's it's like, dude, now you're a man, you know, like, and you got little men, you know, like kids. And he said to me, he said, yeah, House, all of us grew up but you. And I was like, yeah, but I'm living the dream, motherfucker. I'm living the dream, you know. And then I thought about it for a while, you know. I'm kind of quick on my feet. I grew up with passive-aggressive people, so they try to, like, jab you, like, real quick and run away. You know, so, like, you know, people do that junk, try to jab you. But I'm a little bit slow, so I made a joke about it, and then I got mad. You know, and then I went back and I said, you know, stress don't mean growth. Mm. And age doesn't mean wealth.
Show about this kind of thing, you know, like in 30 years it'll be a completely different story because you know, 20 years ago nothing was being recorded, you know, like hardly anything. Now everything's on YouTube, everything's everywhere, you know. If someone's like, yo, I used to be this, you can go up on, you know, YouTube, you know, check out their name and be like, yo, you were whack, shut up.
Yeah, I know, like, yeah, there's definitely a vetting process, you know, like, now, you know. And but isn't that like, isn't there some accountability in that?
Yeah.
You know, maybe that'll make us an honest society, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, maybe, you know, because there's proof of what we did, there's a record, you know? Like, it makes me think about, like, artists who, like, there's no living record of them. Like, Master Juba.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, people write about him, you know, like, you know, like he was a, you know, heaven sent on earth dancing, the best dancer that ever lived, you know, like, and I wonder what that looks like, you know, like, well, I never see it. I mean, they didn't have cameras back then for him to record himself, like.
Yeah, they got like a flipbook.
Yeah, they could have done that. They could have flipbooked him.
That actually opens up a whole nother conversation or idea for me. Like, we're talking about OGs and elders as people, mm-hmm. but what if we talked about it in terms of, like, dance styles? Like, what styles have we forgotten? Like, what styles have we built on and not done our history on, or not...
not continued or sustained?
Yeah. What dances have we let die?
Yeah.
Or have we pushed out of the cipher? Or pushed out?
No. Let that die.
We don't let that die.
Let the Dougie die.
No, the Soulja Boy.
But see, those are all ones that are recorded now. Like, we've got plenty of images and plenty of videos on the Dougie and all these random crappy dances. Yeah. But
that's what the aliens think about us.
Yeah, exactly. I can't wait to explain to my kids what Superman that hoe means.
There's also a question of that super saturation. Like, when you have so much video and so much archiving of all these different things, how do you decide what's important? Who decides what's important anymore?
Whoever's trying to push a message.
Pat. Message.
Message.
That's what's up. No, I agree.
I mean, we have the same thing in, you know, the cultural news and, like, you know, national news. There's plenty of proof of everything that's going on out there, but, you know, you can spin whatever story from whatever footage you want to use.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What crappy footage doesn't make it onto YouTube? Like,
no, that's true.
No one records their beginning crappy days and wants to have it up there and wants to show, like, I was once really, really bad.
But so many
no
people
one shows
do.
A progression. Like,
so many people post everything they do on YouTube, and you're like, why?
They're just not honest enough to admit it.
Yeah, they think. You know.
Oh, great.
This is dope.
Yeah.
But I think there is a lot of people stopping and thinking about that now. People are having these conversations about, you know, what's relevant, you know, and they're having these, you know, reflective moments where they're saying, hey, what have we forgotten? Who have we forgotten? You know? Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people just have the mindset of what's relevant, you know, what makes me relevant, how can I pull it back into the loop? And every now and then, some old person is sitting back, like, mm-hmm. not thinking about it again, and someone finds the opportunity to come and shake the dust off of them and say, hey, look, you know, this is what this person's doing, you know, and I'm associated with them.
For a nominal fee.
Yeah. For a nominal fee, you could be associated with that too. Yeah.
Mm.